Thank you. When I met you at the church and you introduced yourself, I was like, in fact, I was telling Jeremy, you know, when she greeted me, I was like, oh, that's a very warm person. I already like her. So thank you so much for opening your home. It's not easy to host. I know how hard it is, even back home. They are where we are going to be. I'm going to be here. So I'm really grateful, even for allowing me to come into your home. Asante ni sana. Ndigucokera maundu maingi Jeremy auga. No he maundu ingienda to add a little bit because ndũĩ wathiũrũrũka nĩ ũthiaga ũkĩmenyaga maundu na ũgĩthikagĩrĩria andũ na ũkĩiguaga meciria ma andũ. One of the things ngoretwo ngĩigua kũrĩ andũ mokĩte gũkũ na mokire gatene na makarerera ciana gũkũ. And I have two witnesses, kana adweri, tukoretwo tukĩaria nao. So when they come here, ciana cigoka either ciĩ nini kana magaciarĩrwo gũkũ. So when you talk to those people and tell them to invest back home, it's really hard. Tondũ maugaga, ciana irereirwo kĩ? Irereirwo America, they have nothing to do with Kenya. Angĩ makauga, ciana ndarereire kĩ? America. So they are not interested in Kenya at all. So I have found people who have gotten shocked when they come back home with their children. One of them is my auntie. She came home with her daughter and her daughter said, you know what, mom? I'm not going back to the US. This is it. I have found a place. I am getting a job here and this is where I'm staying. No, she no more, no, orereiro ke. Woko America. Yesterday I met a girl. She's actually in Springfield. When she started investing with me, she was 23 years old. Na nini nyadaga ku encourage adwanini because I know hegedomoto tathomire ria tutari anini. Nobody told us you can do this, you can do that. So when I hear a young person who wants to invest, I am really, really encouraged. So when she spoke to me, the brother and the wife, they had invested with us. So makimwera, why don't you take something? Now that you started working, oyake, kanyamu. So she called me and told me, Jane, I really want something. What do you have? Gibutumira map. How far is it from my brother's plot? It's a walking distance. Oh, okay. So what do you recommend? Gimwera, you can take nabai. Digirikanayari naberiko. I think it was 22 or something. Akejira Jane, you know me, I'm very young and can you give me gehanaga miari tadatu maximum. Akejoria, can you give me 8 months? Gemwera, because you are very young, I will give you, I'll accommodate you. Tukiandikanira agreement na tukigoria kuriha. Akiwona nigwamba gutuma matatu nigetha wone this serious. So she sent 300,000 and we started the journey. To cut the long story short, within 3 months, nyari hete broth ya bere. It was going for, I think 1.5 or 1.65, around there. Okay, Joria, how next? Henege, Joy. So I encouraged her. She took another one. Natukia de kandera, naakirekia, naakireha. Now, what really shocked me is that when we were having a conversation with her, I am not the mode of America. I invest back home and go back home. What am I trying to say? Is that there are opportunities back home. It doesn't matter how long you have been here. I've seen a lot of young children. Please don't make a decision that they will stay here and this is their home. They might shock you and decide they're going to go back to Kenya. Because we have seen children who have come and they fall in love with Kenya. You know? So, let them have options. So encourage them, those who are at the age of investing, encourage them to invest even for themselves. The young ones, invest. But have something so that should your children decide to go back, they have something to fall back to. So this is something I have come to learn. For me, it was an eye-opener. Hearing it from the youngsters that actually they are choosing to come back home and stay there. Whilst their parents had already made a decision that this is it. We have other people because these are real life our stories. People come here na makouga nitwakinya na gukoto tikouma. I have one great friend that bereje kwedia migoda ngimwera my friend ye dread ya ke migoda aya kejera jeni re now all my children are born here. I cannot invest back home. Ngimwera hatikire thina. Then Trump happened. Kejera jeni brotire wa ugaga sieko. So we started the journey with her, and through her I have actually sold maybe about 70 plots, because after that she brought her friends, she would invite me to her house, she bring people together, because she realized maundu ni macenja ni macenjagia ni gukaga uto I mean yeah utaraire good ni guriganiithu ni gukaga utaraire. So because of those eventualities na no igwe maisha ni mega muno na uge guku ni kugaikara, but in years to come kaudoga kuigera wigwe riu ai no I need to go back. The question is, what are you going back to? So it is important to know ati ona ngicoka umuthi ni njo ya ndu macokete magoka guku na maka accumulate bia tondu bia ni kuoneka nima. But if you don't do anything with that money after accumulating it, money loses value. But if you have put in an investment, it gains value. Kwogo no ngiciga bengi ukacieke majika ndungihota gwika maundu maria uratanya gwika atia gwika kuria andu mokaga na mbeca nyingi, and that's the time they want to start. Nitoka na bia na briefcase, you want to do to buy a home, you want to do this, it doesn't work. Within 2 years makona ai acha turudi America tukachape kazi. So it's good to plan for any eventuality. Even if you feel that this is it, just say anything can happen. And again, yokwedia kindu kiu ke mucie, because as we said, things appreciate very fast, and you invest back here, nothing stops you. College education is not cheap. Now we are brought in Aruiru East, dregera mwanoe wa miaka 5 agikinya miaka ya gudi college no brought you geka atia ganywa thoko. And it really gives you options, and the options are unlimited. So nigwendaga kuheana ka background kau, because of somebody who may be there mudu na twana tonindi, you know what to do. And I'm grateful because they got na support nyingi, at least the drama nyahe na customer wako ha homwe whom we've journeyed together. And I am grateful for the people who have continued to support me na reme ukinyonera haha. And one of the things that really makes me happy ni testimonials iria ru andu maheaga makanyandikira makanjira Jane, thank you so much, you have helped us invest. And that is what brings us joy, kuona ati ni twanyita mundu guoko na ndiahota kwinyitira kanyamu na ndanagia stress ndagaga toro ati kanyamu kau ni agutunywo. When you invest with us, you have peace of mind. That is what we guarantee as Amara Realty. So we have many projects. Jeremy has spoken about Ruiru East. Ruiru East una project hiyo na niguthirara thireyo ehakuhi na bypass 500 meters. But we also have one that is not so close to the proposed Greater Eastern Bypass irakwo. We also have that. Na ni jugaga, Ruiru East, it doesn't matter how close you are to the bypass, the proposed bypass, because bypass hiyo itinarigia Ruiru East Mwalimu Farm into two. Either we mwenoyo, kana we mwenoyo, it doesn't really matter. And I was giving an example of Meble. Kure arama kuhere iri arami, na kure arame theini. It doesn't matter where you are. Kana we theini, in fact, if you go to Meble where people are living in their own residential homes, they prefer to be inside. So it doesn't matter where you are. Whether you're on this side or where, Ruiru East is a place that right now is highly affordable. Baadhi ya hetoka, tadoro bypass ya kwa, tena toro ugaga, the Greater Eastern Bypass will be built. The Greater Eastern Bypass will be built. Ado makajuria ega kwa, the gamera for sure, I don't know, but I know it will be done. Because it's already there, it's planned for. I remember having a conversation with one of the people who are in charge of Kenha. Na gemuria bypass yu nori, ya Greater Eastern Bypass re. And that was, I think, last year, towards the end of last year. Gemuria Greater Eastern Bypass yu nori, what's the story? Okay, Jera, it's funny that you asked me about it, because yesterday we were actually discussing it. So that gave me hope that it is something that is going to happen. So listening to the CS of Roads, Kipchumba Murkomen, saying that that road is going to be done next year, to me, it's a breath of fresh air. Tondu kaundu karia ngoragwo ngira andu riu ni karoka ke into the light. Kwoguo, I would encourage somebody, angikorwo hena kamuthithu weigeire, that is a great place to invest. It doesn't matter kana urenda kuinvest ugaka kana kuinvest nigetha ucokanirie kamuthithu gaku ukendia. Whatever it is, it's a great place to invest. Kwoguo, karibu sana Reverend Morris. Mutugati Rio ni one welcome in Boston. The last time I came, he's the one who welcomed me. Ona nowe urahigurire mirango ya guka kanitha kwanyu. So thank you so much, Reverend Morris. Yes. So niguo ngugaga, it doesn't matter where you are in Ruiru East, you will gain. You will gain whether it is for investment, kana niguaka mucie, you are home and dry. Nodoge, Jeremy, I don't know whether digwishia ni ahutirie. Nitugera ya kuhe adu options. No muno nitugera ya ku encourage adu magore kedu kinena nene. We know Kenya, we are used to buying 50 by 100, which is not a bad plot. No tugaga, why don't you consider buying 100 by 100? Todu waka mushi waku on 100 by 100. We na ke waja kine nagia weka maudu maige. Nyuku hada bogashi yaku. Na nyuku corona grounds. Oge host ya do. Nyuku corona parking shiaku. There's so much you can do with it. So we encourage people to go a bit larger. So if you see our options and if you go to our website, nyuku wana, most of the projects we have 100 by 100. No mudu wageiwe nereda, another 50 by 100, we also are flexible as far as that is concerned. So, kioriane, nwangi tuero horo wa Ruiru East, what are the prizes? Ruiru East, tuna project hiru wi igere, emwenego direra adira, eyo ya 500 meters to the proposed bypass. Neyo iradhiye for 1.94, if you buy cash, that's 100 by 100. If you pay in 6 months, it's 2.1. And when a project yege, which is slightly about maybe 2.5 kilometers or 3, less than 3 kilometers to the proposed bypass, nayo irauma 1.75 if you pay cash, and if you pay installments, is 1.88, just 6 months. So that is what we have. Na that is Ruiru East. We also have an amazing project. Na duwishi ya bjara menia hutia muno. It's called the Oint Country Homes. Na ishishie kudogweta go Gataga. Actually, it's thicker. Tadu nejera yoyago di Gataga. Kuma blue post to where we are is only 8 kilometers. Na kuhundi kwa tuga ganemu dhaiga wa adheka. So mudu wage wani ya rada nyoba, that's another place. And our homes, if you go and do your survey, are more Dika Greens. Dika Greens, they build their homes, or Kanado Magora Gashia Shia, 100 by 100, and they build their homes. If you go and check for a home that is on sale in Dika Greens, Nyumukona Dogora. And for us, we are selling those homes at 24.8. Houses built on 100 by 100, 4 bedrooms, all in suit. It has a DSQ. It has 2 living rooms, it has 2 kitchens, it has a great terrace. It's an amazing place. Negweda, just watch the video that we have done for that home and you'll be able to see the kind of home that we are building. We have done a home that is different. We have gone out of our way to research and see what is it that people would want. Nekeke wogehe ado. Mudu ikuwe ni indiredaga dream home, but actually this is my dream home. Tikedora ugareke gore mushi for the sake of buying a home, but you're buying a home because ne akwari diya no one, that is your dream home. So that is what we have with the Oint Country Homes. So, yeah, thank you very much. Yes.
Thank you. Makomi mazuri kwa CEO. Thank you very much.
God bless you so much. Na ninajua nitawapea nafasi muulize maswali. Nijiguile mudu wetuo Jega wa Migatea kiugati. Adu ni matunye tuwa huku na daigu wa kiuga. Kasikia kisema. Sijua matine kunasikia kikuyu. Umefunzwa kabisa? Haya, sawa. Daigwa jega kiuga ati kwe kundu ginya andu mathia makenderio migunda ina kafuri. I mean, todo mwe diaspora people take advantage of you guys. But I will tell you this. Me as Jeremy, I tell people the truth and I like speaking the truth. Todo the truth will set me free. And I have seen it fighting for me, the truth. Hata wakati niko chini sana. So it fights. So me, I will tell you this. The land she's selling here ya Roiro East. Roiro is in Kiambu County. Na jega todo kwa nyine le muru. Nwe ginya le muru yo miguna de ahutika. Another time somebody was calling me from Tigoni actually. I think she's from Boston, I think. She was telling me she's selling, I think, 3 acres. Na weka moja likuwa na nitia 32 million. Gyabagi ugabu. Nikamwambia mimi hata siwezi jenga Tigoni. Huko ni mashabani. Akaniambia hapana, wewe kuja uone. Imagine an acre 32 million. Na Tigoni juzi tu bado ni ile ile tu. Hakuna kitu kimeongezwa Tigoni because ni manyumba, ni mashamba ya watu. So what she's saying when she tells you about Roiro East. What she has not said is kuna shamba Ruto alikuwa amenyaganywa na Uhuru. Ndio hiyo. Mnashimeshwaisikia hiyo kuna shamba alikuwa amenyaganywa. Sasa hiyo shaba mahali iko hapo ndio rami ilikuwa imefika because the government fenced the whole land. Sasa kutoka kwa hiyo rami mpaka kwa shaba hiyo anaongea is 1.9 kilometer. Na Ruto kulingana na venye sasa hatuna uhakika hii project ya housing ameanza. She has said hiyo haistahili kuwa sewage, inastahili kuwa nyumba. So he's planning to do his housing project anasema zinajengwa hapo. So just imagine if he's the president today, hata tuseme atatoka 2030 ama 2027 and he has interest with that place, do you think he will develop it in 2050? Because he's the president, ataanza saa hii. So what we are telling you guys, hiyo Kamakis, I thank God because Mambitris ni kwao ni hapo. Si ni hapo hiyo 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 hivyo. So you go to Kamakis today, people are being told hapa kutakuwa na bypass. Anauza bypass ni jizyo nini sasa? Now today, enda hapo ulize, Kamakis, ask for 1 acre. About ni kapo inatoka pesa ngama ngapi?
You'll get it between 60 to 100.
Million. 1 acre. Na pahali tunakuzia ni nyuma ya hapo. Actually, it's 10 minutes. I mean, it's just the river. Ni kukross the river. Uingie sasa hiyo Roiro East. And me, I will tell you this. Take the advantage. Hata sasa, kuna siku nilimwambia, but hata sasa ya kuuza 100 by 100. Sasa zingine watu nalipigia zima. Jamie, tunataka brought ya pesa kidogo, nikamwambia sukate basi ya 50 by 50. Badala nikisema ukisema ni 1.92 million kwa sababu ni 100 by 100, useme sasa ikiwa ni 50 by 50 itakuwa 900,000. Unajua watu wetu wanatakaga ya pesa kidogo, lakini ni kaspesi kidogo. Useme ati wacha ninunue ya 900 unishikanishie tuwili. Ni the same thing. Na ndio tunajaribu kuavoid. Ati wewe kata useme ni 900 ama 1 million alafu mwingine anasema nishikanie tu tatu. Eh? Si afadhali uchukue the whole 100 by 100 yenye iko na title moja. Badala ya ushikanishiwe sasa ukue na title hii. So you see what I'm saying? So me I'll tell you guys, hata wenye hawaendi nyumbani, nyinyi wenye Mungu amekubali mkae hapa, mkae kabisa. Let me tell you guys, you never know tomorrow. Mungu anaweza fungua njia yako ya kwenda nyumbani na kurudi. Lakini ukienda kule niwaambie kitu moja, hawatawachekesha mother. Sio umekuwa nyumbani. Huko hawachekeshi. Anakuangalia hivi anakuambia umeishi Amerika miaka ngapi? Unasema hiyo toa DNA na huna kwako, okay. Weka hapa nakupea chakula siku moja. Siku ya pili wanaanza kukuogea na midomo. Angalia ile kanyumba anakaa, angalia ile gari anaendesha, bovu kabisa. And they will laugh. Watatuchekelea. So let's be smart guys and let's invest with the right people. Na usisikie wengine wakisema sisi tumenyaganywa. Ukisikia mtu akisema amenyaganywa, muulize, hebu niambie ulinyaganywa wapi. I'll tell you 99% of the people who say they have been nyaganywa, hakuna mtu amemnyaganya. Alisikia story. That's the truth. Mwenye amenyaganywa atakwambia the whole story. Mimi si wai nunua na hii kampuni inaitwa fulani. Nilinunua, hawajawahi nipatia title. Lakini ukisikia mtu ah, sisi hatu muulie, muite vizuri. Hebu ngoja, uliinvest na kampuni gani? Hata sijui ilikuwa inaitwa namna gani. Ujue huyo ni mkora yeye mwenyewe. So please guys, don't jenga nyumba yako kama wengine. Tumesikia hapa, tulikuwa tunaongea na Bwana Ngugi na watu wengine hapa, tukasikia ati kuna misala zilirushwa na nini inaitwa nani, inaitwa umesema ni gani, Iran ikatuma Israel. Nguni Mungu ni mzuri kadaiva tu. Over 300 missile, hiyo si missile kidogo. Just imagine. Sasa kukuja tu kikitu missile kama tano hivi ziharibu zikuje Boston. I'm just giving an example. Haiwezi kuja. Mungu atulinde sisi sote. Ama zipite tu. Si unajua hii dunia na kila watu wanataka kuonyeshana nguvu zake. Zipite tu zianze kuja America. Zianze kuja America. Zianze kuja America. Tutaanza kufanya nini? Wewe utaenda Mexico. Utaenda Mexico. Let's be realistic. Who promised us that this will be safe? Aguna, so home is always home. And that is why you have that identity of a Kenyan. Because huku kiambiwa kuambiwa hoi hoi hoi, watu hapa wataenda Haiti. Na wewe utaenda nyumbani. There's a difference. Sasa ukienda nyumbani, watakuimbia siku moja haleluya. Siku ya pili utaanza kwenda kwa kahawa kama wao. Na watakucheka. Utajaribu kuambia Amerika nilikuwa naendesha la 4, nilikuwa naendesha Mercedes, kambia modu. Wacha kutudanganya nitoe wala baje tu shosho gani. So please guys, let's see tomorrow. And as Ashia said about our kids, pia sisi, let's build our Kenya. Me, my daughter plays soccer and she plays with Mexican. Tukienda soccer, hawa watoto wadogo hivyo unasikia ananiambia, "Eh, bien, mucho ya caliente." And they are same age, 9 years. Wanacheza mpira, "Eh, mucho ya caliente." They are speaking Spanish and they are still in the same school. My daughter alimwambia, "Ukana huko. Daddy, what are you saying? I don't like that language." My friend, mukosa mira ni mtumwa. Let's not push our kids to that place of lacking identity. Let that person be proud. Anaitwa Tinega. Kwa ni huko omulo musi? Nyamatogo. Kwa ni bani ni Nyamatogo. You see these people here, they are spending a lot of money kwenda kutafuta identity. The black people. And if you don't give your child identity, when you'll not be here, she'll be just like them. Ataanza kwenda Nigeria. Naenda Nigeria ambia wewe si Nigeria. Hiyo masikio ni ya Wakenya. So why don't you teach them? Be happy. Sit them down. Waambie, "I am a doctor here. You are becoming a BSN. But my friend, nyumbani ni Kenya. Sisi tumetoka Nyamatogo. Mimi nawaambiaga nimetoka Gego. Na nikienda Kenya nawapelekaga nawaambia dada yangu alikuwa analala hapa kwa kahawa hii." So when she grows up, na namwambia, namuonyesha opportunities. Those people like Kirobi, they have invested with big farms. Unashinda huyo jamaa alianza kutoa pesa wapi? Labda alipata nafasi ya kwenda tu Marekani akaanza kupata tu pesa akaweka kibusiness. There are people, even if you give them visa free, they will not come here. Why? Because Kenya money iko, my brother. Na kuna mtu anakuuliza unapeleka wapi? You just need to be smart. Weenda Kenya, uende uchukue ile kakali ya rento, ile Probox ama ile Fielder. Uambie rafiki yako mwenye mliacha Kenya mkutane pale Kamaki simkule nyama. Uniambie ile gari anakuja nayo. My brother, hutasema wewe unaishi America. Because people are blessed. Wanakuja na V8 unashindwa gari ya milioni 15. Alafu anakupeleka kwake unashindwa modu. Kwani wewe ni mwizi? Kwambia hapana, ni kujipanga. So for us, if you are in America, don't be lied. People in Kenya are investing and they have business and they have big money. So for you, if you kisikia kakitu kapo ni genuine, wewe chukua weka. Hiyo pesa yako uko nayo 100,000. Enda uniambia at the end of the year itakuwa imekupa interest ya pesa ngapi? 0.1. Ama ni watu wangapi? Mimi kuna siku nilikuwa na tu pesa kidogo kwa bank. Nikaletewa $71. Ati ndio interest ya huru ya. 71. Ai, simuniambia ni uongo. Uko na 100,000 unaitoa $71. Unashitwa Jesus, pesa yangu na imelala pale kwa bank. Lakini hao banks si wajinga, wanajua kwenye wanapeleka hizo pesa. They enrich themselves. Na wewe tu unaonga masaa, unaonga masaa, hata huwezi kutembea kwa barabara juu ya masaa. So let's be smart. Let's take advantage of a dollar to invest Kenya. Weka. Last time dollar ilikuwa 160. Nilikuwa naambia watu, "Guys, this is the time. Hiyo property tulikuwa tunaiuza tu 1.9. dollar iko 160. Saa hizi iko 125. Na Zakayo amesema itakuja 99. Ndego ka? Ndego ni atodo na baba itoma yuka huko America 1993. Yale dola 40. Yale shiki 40. Na no mato ile. Gile tiguo. So now we don't know about tomorrow. So jenga na wale wengine. I'll tell you, let's be ambassadors of support. Even if you don't buy, when we have genuine people, let us give them opportunity. Wauzie watu na tuendelea hivyo. Sindo hiyo? So I'm believing you guys are going to be my neighbors.
Where? You have so many places.
Mimi niko na Kwigi, lakini nawaambia saizi Roiro. Because mimi hata mimi mwenyewe nimejenga tu Roiro. My home iko Juja. Juja na Ruiru, because one day I'll be the member of parliament for that area.
Amen.
When I hit miaka hiyo ya kuritaya, sasa mimi nitakuwa kule bunge nikuonyesha venye mambo inapangwa. I don't know how I get there, but I'll be. So when you become my neighbors, nitawashtuga. Wengine wakipiga ati kwao hakuna barabara, mimi nawaambia watu wangu msijali. Nimepewa milioni 100 kutengeneza barabara, na mimi sikuli pesa yenu. Mimi niko na mshahara wangu, bora msifikie mshahara yangu. Milioni yenu 100 naiweka kwa barabara, naiweka kwa choo, naiweka kwa nini kitu, miti tunapanda, tunakaa in our own beautiful estate. So please guys, how can we do that? Is when she has a project like that, tunaichukua tunaidadia. Akipata nyingine tunaichukua tunaidadia. Wakati wetu wa kufika, hata kama hutajenga, you can sell that property and it will give you money. Anyway, you will remember me when that bypass itajengwa. God bless you so much. And of course, she has also lands in Nanyuki. Hajasema Nanyuki, she's selling. Wale watu wanatanganga quantity. Si quality, quantity. Akona 1 acre, anauza 1.75 million. 1.75 million. Hiyo ni eka moja. Na mnakumbuka bwana James, like 2 years ago, tulinunua eka moja. Pesa ngapi? 300. Nanyuki, 300. 2 years. Saa hizi tunaongea kuhusu 1.75. Saa hizi na Salova Hotels zimeenda Nanyuki. We have billionaire clubs, hotels, those big things. So you huwezi jipa sababu ya kukosa kuinvest na Jenny. So tumpigia makofi mazuri. Tena yeye ni mama. Yeah? Tena yeye ni mama. I mean, and one other thing about her is that siogei sana kuhusu yeye. Hajanilipa na leo utanilipa tafadhali. It's because I've seen her heart, what she does. Every time I have a project in Kenya, nasaidia mtu kujenga, yeye ndiye anachip fast. Ati alisema, because I'm believing that I'll have my estate ya kujengea watu, ananipea foundation ya mawe. Yeye ndiye anazanga. Sasa zingine muuliza, wewe acha kunipea, ngoja tugojee mwenyaka atupatie na yeye pia. Naambia hapana, that's a commitment with me and God. Ananipatia naenda najenga. So when she comes here, it doesn't mean she has a lot of money, but she wants your support. Si ndio hiyo? Financia. Hata ukipeleka watu kwa insurance tafadhali, usiwadanganye sana, waambie tu warudi kwa mashaba. Because shaba ndio haipotezi. Kuna mtu ako na swali tukimalizia? Kwa hizo project zote tumeuliza. Hata kama Tinega, kuna swali? Ama utauliza ama anauza nyama tu?
Mimi nasikia ya nyumba ikiwa afadhali, sijui inaendaje ya nyumba. Hiyo ya Thika.
Hiyo ya Thika. Okay.
Aya, hiyo ya Thika, you'll put a deposit of 4.65. The construction period is 18 months. So the rest of the amount will be paid within the 18 months. Yes, during the construction period. Yes, 24.8 million. We are breaking ground in June by God's grace. That's when we want to break ground. So once we break ground, ni kuendelea. Yes. It's a gated community, extremely beautiful. Out of this world, let me put it that. In fact, most people who have seen it, they're just wowed. Even those people in Kenya, they are like, wow, this is amazing. Everybody who has seen it, they're just wowed and they just want to, you know, they want to experience that home. Because what we have done is that we've created not just homes, but an experience. At the Waigera code, Waigera into four walls, kana whatever number of walls that are there. But we are giving you an experience. Okaigua ni wakinya moshie, na moshio shonyo reda Waigera. So every room gives you an experience. And gweshiria negwaretie tuikorea. Na goga, like now when you go to the master bathroom, we toke bereria kwediere, we had no thought about it. But later we thought, okay, we have gone to some elegant homes. Taruhenyo by Gedadite in Hurlingham. Nyobe shosheda yo 120 million. Na yaketo na 50 by 100. But that home, when you get into the bathroom, instead of having a concrete ceiling, you have a glass ceiling. So when you are there, you can be able to see what is... I mean, you can be able to see the skies and the stars. When you're going up the stairway, we've also created that experience that you're inside the house, but you can actually experience the outside world when you're inside the house. Yes. So those are some of the things that we have done. So 4.65 million is what you put down. The rest you pay within the construction period of 18 months. Yes.
Thank you. Okay.
Yes.
By the way, yes. Nimesema hiyo shamba mimi mwenyewe nimefanya grad. Okay, go ahead.
Now, like 24 million. In case that I don't want to take long before I develop.
Okay. Nianza kidogo. Tulia kwa kihana ati ya kaduka na kikorugo mwodo wa igue. Toda kwa gira milio ni 24. Aligedi nego ikala igirage so kariya siya kwa kari. Do you guys help like in case you want to develop the plot? Kana inyo na okuwe dia tu. Kana ni mwodo ya domagita idile dia. No, the
mm-hmm.
E prot, the protein. Mm-hmm. Oh, okay. Okay. Yeah, that's good.
Okay.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
Kyoria yakwanerere. Twego kuniturona do like the company like yours marakirado adumagurite plot. Do you guys do that? Oh, okay. Okay.
Probably
okay.
Graduate
to that level.
Okay.
All right.
Step by step.
Step by step.
Yeah.
All right. If you go there, I'll be the first one.
Thank you. Let me say this. I wish to get one kitu to onyesha your video, but I'll make sure I'll send that video to you guys because I know I have most of your contact. You go through that video because that house, let me tell you, my friend, it's a good house. Here, I mean, it's a good house. I don't, could I hear flyers? What is it, the flyers, by the way? You should.
Oh,
YouTube?
Yeah.
Oh, hebu tuwekewe YouTube. Tutafiksiwa hapo. Nitaonyesha hiyo nyumba. So, na sasa wale wanataka kujengewa, if you have, because I have had watu wakisema I have plot, nataka kujengewa. The problem with that is I would tell you hata kama ni benki kuja ikuambie ikujenge, itakula percentage yake, which will be very expensive for you. Mimi naambianga mtu kama uko na plot, we aza kujenga pole pole. Ukipata mawe bili, wewe weka pale. Bora kwanza ucholewe nyumba na ukue na watu waaminifu. Mimi ukinituma hapo najua vizuri sana. Project management, I'm good. Bora unilipe vizuri. Hakuna kitu utapoteza hapo. That's what I've been doing to help our people. So if you have a house ilikwama ama unajengewa mahali, wewe tell me. I'll go check it in my own ways. Takuja uku advice baadaye. So we are trying to do Amara Realty tutafute hapo. So another question before tuwekewa hiyo video ya nyumba yenye anajenga? Okay, yes sir.
Now, there is three questions. One, here we are 500 meters from the bypass. You're saying they are almost sold out, right? You didn't tell us how much is left.
Okay.
Let me just consolidate all my questions. And you know, in terms of the amenities, is here or to TQA, we have not seen it. You know, assume I don't know. I really don't know to TQA. So we need to know how many are left, and what are the amenities that you can have here. Because you know, my is very important. Bypass. You talked about it being what 1.9 kilometers from the proposal.
No, that's the same one.
It's the same one.
Yeah.
So Taivitore, Kenya, then maybe perhaps we can get a good geography of it.
Yes.
So I'm trying to imagine it, east and west, in Korea, you know, Mwalimu east and west, I have no clue. And then the third one, Kataga. I'm assuming it's Pastika.
Yes. I don't know where
they
blue
post
the
other. Okay.
You live Gita Road.
Okay. Okay. So that one is 100 by 100.
Yes.
And it says 24 million complete. That includes 100 by 100 and the complete house. My question is,
we have two designs,
uh-huh,
but they are technically the same. Same size, the only difference is the orientation.
Because I've seen places, SDT, we have two designs, 100 to 100. And you know, you women don't like, you know, ogera mutumio ge na gweta kunwebia ukashia joko do kwa da gwe, or you want another one. So please answer those questions.
Now, before she answer that question, I would want to give you a highlight of that video venye iko, so that we can meona sasa umeelezewa vizuri. You can go sit down and watch it again. And I'm saying that when she's saying it's 24.8 million, it's not the last price. She's gonna go up. So if you are able to, wewe ya kanyamu uko na kamushiga kwa mudhaiga ya dhika. From Blue Post Hotel there is 8 minutes. Thank you. Aya, any other question?
Yes.
Yes, please.
So I was asking I was doing a little bit of a math here. The down payment is about $36,000. Mm-hmm. When you talk to the whole amount is about $190,000, getting close to $200,000.
Mm-hmm.
So do you have like a company that can finance that? Because majority of the people might be willing, but they may not have that cash at hand. Because it's a lot of money too.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, let me answer that. I've not forgotten your questions, so I'll also get back to that. So in terms of the company that can finance, we have partnered with Housing Finance. We've agreed that once somebody pays, I think between 20-30% of the cost of the house, they are able to finance, and they will do that in piecemeal. As we build, they continue releasing so that, you know, you're not stretched, and they are able to release as you build. The only disclaimer would be the interest rates, which you'd need to discuss with them, because now those are commercial rates. Yes. Yeah, but yes, we have that partnership with Housing Finance, and they are able to actually walk the journey with us as we do the construction. Yes. Kiregia kukiuma geography area. So the geography of Ruiru East is as follows. Ruiru East is in between Kamakis. So from Kamakis, if you're on Thika Road, and you're going towards the airport, that road is Eastern Bypass, right? So on this side, we have Northland City. And if you go ahead, you'll find part of the Northland City. And by the way, Northland City has been built a lot. It's so much not open to many people, but if you go inside, there's a lot happening in Northland City. Northland City is the land that is owned by the former First family, the Uhuru family. So that's Northland City. So if you come to this other side and you have the Northland City on the left-hand side, you go down with that, if this is their fence, you go down with that fence, you get to the river, you cross the river, Koniko Ruiru East Mwalimu Farm. So on one side is Northland City, Kamakis, and then you cross the river, you go to Ruiru East Mwalimu Farm. Now, that road has not been done. And that's a road we are saying is linking, will link the Eastern Bypass to the Greater Eastern Bypass. So instead of us now going round, currently we go round, we go to Roy Quick Mart, and we go back as if you're going towards Juja Farm. So that's the current geography. And that's why he was saying from the end of that tarmac road that we use to where now those properties or the land that we are saying that is almost sold out is only 1.9 kilometers. So it's a walking distance. You come with a tarmac, you can walk. It's a walking distance to where the land is. So that is a geography of the area. And when you are there at Ruiru East, you see now you've come through Ruai. So one side now it will border Ruai, on the other side it borders Juja Farm. So if you have an idea of those three places, you can be able to place where Mwalimu Farm is. The other question was...
about the amenities.
Oh, the amenities. Okay. If you look at the brochure, one of the things we do, we secure our projects. Okay? In a negate, yeah, one of our projects. I believe this is Sifa 3 Gardens. Sifa Phase 3 Gardens. This one. So this is the first thing we do. We secure our land. So we build a very fantastic gate. And then we put an electric fence with poles, not with maves. So we put an electric fence and we grade the roads. Now, there are projects and several projects that do have water, but we have some projects that do not have water. Now, a good example, if I talk about now this one that we are selling, the Praise Gardens Phase 2, which is the one that we are talking about right now, that is 500 meters to the proposed bypass. Now, that project is somebody who has actually bought a plot there specifically so that they can drill a borehole. But within the area, we have somebody who is already supplying water to people, because that area, we do not have city council water, because this is an area that is developing. It's an area that is growing. So we do not have city council water. So people rely on borehole water. So we already have somebody who is supplying people water there, but we have one of our own who actually asked me, Jane, don't drill a borehole. I want to drill a borehole and be the supplier of water in that place. So that's another, what's happening there. And in most of our projects, we have people who are actually saying, we would want to drill a borehole, because water business is a great business. So they would want to drill borehole. So where we can't drill a borehole as a matter of reality, we have clients or customers who are willing to do that. But we have a lot of borehole water within the area. Yes.
So now that's in the little places not developed. We have shopping centers, we have what's around.